Welcome to part one of building Ibis EMI model for high speed SERDES devices. My name is Sanjeev Gupta. I am signal integrity applications specialist with E sub division of Agilent Technologies. In this presentation, I will give a brief introduction to Ibis EMI model, why these models are required and how to create these models. I will be taking a simple example of a PCI Express Gen 2 transmitter creates its algorithmic representation, simulate for its system performance, and then create Ibis AMI model. We will verify the Ibis AMI model performance using ADS channel simulator. A high-speed serial link can be divided into three functional blocks, the transmitter IC, the passive channel, and receive IC. In order to achieve high data rate and to recover signal correctly, a high-speed digital system uses various signal processing techniques within transmitter and receiver. These signal processing techniques or functionality cannot be accurately represented using traditional Ibis model, and therefore Ibis committee decided to release another standard which they called Ibis algorithmic modeling interface. An Ibis AMI model is represented by two parts, the regular Ibis model and the AMI extension. The regular Ibis stage represents the analog portion of Ibis AMI model and accounts for all the impedance mismatch between the driver and receiver IC and the passive channel. The AMI extension represents the signal processing functionality of transmit and receive IC. The Ibis AMI standard defines the communication mechanism between an EDA tool and the Ibis AMI model. The standard does not provide any guidance on how to represent various signal processing blocks used to represent SERDES device, such as decision feedback equalizer, feedforward equalizer, CTLE, or transmit de-emphasis. The task is left to the semiconductor vendor to create these functional block and create C++ code. The Ibis AMI model is represented by a combination of three files. The .ibis file represents the analog I/O stage of the IC. The .ami file defines the model type and provide all the parameter to be used by the signal processing stage. The .dll file or .so file is the actual C++ model compiled into .dll or shared object on Linux system. The Ibis AMI standard defines three functions which provides a means of communication with an EDA tool, the init function, getWave function, and close function. Init function is used to initialize the memory and compute impulse response of the device and communicate with EDA tool. The getWave function communicates the time domain voltage waveform between EDA tool and Ibis AMI model. The goal of this presentation is to establish a Ibis AMI model generation flow for your SERDES device. I will be starting with a simple example of a PCI Express Gen 2 transmitter, creates its algorithmic representation, simulate for the performance, and then convert the design into an AMI model. To start with, let us look at the broad specifications. The data rate for PCI Express Gen 2 is 5 gigabit per second. The transmitter uses an equalization or de-emphasis of 3.5 dB. The rise and fall time is defined as 30 picoseconds between 20% to 80%. The voltage level for single-ended design can vary from 2.7 to 3.3 volts, and the output impedance is 100 ohm differential. From these specifications, we need to decide which portion of the specifications can be realized using the AMI stage and which portion we need to realize using the analog Ibis stage. So here, I have decided to realize the de-emphasis and the rise and fall time performance using the DSP stage, while the analog Ibis stage will be used to shift the voltage level between 2.7 volts to 3.3 volts, and the output impedance of 100 ohm will be realized there. I will be using a system level product from Agilent Technologies ESOF division, which we call System View. It is an ESL product and can be used to create system architecture. This is System View design environment. On the left side, we have workspace tree, which is used to organize various design within the project. The middle window is the schematic window. Here we will create the PCI Express transmitter representation using the part library provided on the right side of this window. System View comes with exhaustive part library of wireless and wireline systems. We can create the complete system architecture using these library components. To create a PCI Express transmitter, let us start with adding a subnetwork to workspace tree by name PCI Express transmitter. To achieve transmit DM phases, I can use the component by name blind feed forward equalizer. Let us start with adding two parameters to this component. The first parameter I want to add is by name DM phases. The unit for DM phases I will be using is in terms of dB and defining the default value as 3.5 dB. The second parameter I'm adding to this component is samples per bit. I'm using 16 samples to start with as the default value, and you can change this value if required. Given the DM phases value, we need to compute tap coefficient to be used with the feed forward equalizer. For that, we define few equations on the equation page and compute two tap coefficients, which is tap 1 and tap 2, for a given value of DM phases. Let us now come back to the schematic page, edit the feed forward equalizer and define the tap coefficients as tap 1 and tap 2. I define samples per bit as the variable parameter we created, which is samples per bit. This feedforward equalizer will provide us 3.5 dB transmit equalization. Now we have the task remaining to shape the waveform to provide us 30 picosecond rise and fall time. To shape signal transitions from logic level 0 to 1 and vice versa, and to provide 30 picosecond rise time, I will be using a S-domain component at the output of this feedforward equalizer. Let us define an additional parameter to this design. The parameter name is bit time. I assign a default value of 200 picosecond. I also add some additional equations to this design. These equations provide us the location of poles, like pole 1 is located at 8.5 GHz, pole 2 is located at 12 GHz. The third equation compute the gain factor for the S-domain filter. Now let us go back to the schematic page and change the S-domain filter parameters. I start with the sample rate. The sample rate is defined as samples per bit divided by bit time The factor is the equation we defined just now. The poles are located at pole 1 and pole 2. There are no complex conjugate poles, so I can leave this area blank. There are no zeros, and the frequency is defined in terms of Hertz. Now we have created, we have assigned parameter to this S-domain filter, and let us zoom in and see if we are able to see all the required values. Let us assign input and output data port to this subnetwork. And save this design. To generate C++ code for this design,